गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई विद्यासागर वेलकम यू ऑल इन द ई लर्निंग क्लास ऑफ मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल स्टडीज़। आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट सब्जेक्ट हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7 एंड दिस इज फोर्थ वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन द टॉपिक द दिल्ली सुल्तान चैप्टर 3। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, एज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द रूलर्स ऑफ द खिलजी डायनेस्टी एंड तुगलक डायनेस्टी, सो द टू फेमस रूलर्स ऑफ खिलजी डायनेस्टी वॉज अलाउद्दीन खिलजी एज वेल एज द तुगलक डायनेस्टी मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक। एज वी नो दैट बोथ हैविंग द लॉट ऑफ डिफरेंसेस, वन साइड वी विल सी दैट अलाउद्दीन खिलजी विच हैज़ पुट एन इम्प्रेशन दैट कुड विन ऑल ओवर द सब कॉन्टिनेंट, बट ऑन द अदर हैंड साइड वेन वी विल सी अबाउट मोहम्मद बिन तुगलक वी विल सी दैट देयर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एज वेल एज द कंट्रोलिंग पावर्स वॉज नॉट proper through which it could be continued. Like Delhi was attacked twice in 1299 and 30 and 1302 to 1303, as I have told you, by the Mongols, by the Kader Khan during the Alauddin Khilji. Actually it was sequentially attacked 6 times, and Muhammad bin Tughlaq, the Sultanate was attacked in early years of Muhammad bin Tughlaq's and Mongols army defeated. It means at that time they have defeated the Mongols army. Alauddin Khilji, they have constructed the new garrison towns which named was Siri for his soldiers, and on the other hand side Muhammad bin Tughlaq, they did not construct the garrison town, rather than they have constructed a new capital for the peoples of their own kingdom, which was Daulatabad. Next is, they had to collect the taxes to feed their soldiers, and thus they used to collect the taxes from the producing land like the Ganga and Yamuna Doab, as the Khams and Kharas, which was the taxation which was at least 50% at that peasant's yield. And on the other hand side, they also used to produce, and same the taxation was there also, which was produced from the peasants, and further it was for the meeting the requirements of the army. Alauddin Khilji, who had started to pay the salary in cash rather than iktas. It means Alauddin Khilji was the first king who started to pay the salary in cash. He was also one of the price controller king of his kingdoms. Like he also used to control that how the price should be controlled, and he also keep the bandgans to take out of the horses. He also used to give the marked. He also marked the horses, which was one of the famous policy of the Alauddin Khilji. And further, Muhammad bin Tughlaq also paid his soldiers in cash salaries, but instead of controlling price, he used a token currency, as that gold and silvers, the peoples, they used to keep it very well, and they used to exchange with the token currencies. Then Alauddin administrative measure was very strong, as the peoples, they ever used to follow them, because at their time the administration was too much hard, you can say hard, and it was successful because it was enable to control out the prices. Wherever the Muhammad Tughlaq's administrative measure were in failure, the attack to the taxonomia, and he had to gather a large army, thus it led to the failure, and thus he also used to. And when Muhammad Tughlaq's gate failed, sometimes we also used to forget for the first time in history Sultanate that Delhi Sultan planned a campaign to capture the Mongol territory. Unlike the Alauddin's defensive measure, Muhammad bin Tughlaq's measures were conceived part of military offense against the Mongols. It means they were attacking part, but they were defending, and further they also used to rule over that, the Sultanate in the 15th and 16th century. Dear students, as we know that during the 12th centuries, you can say the medieval history. Medieval history was there, and from at the time when from there to the end of the 6th, that time was considered in the medieval history. And further, after the 12th century, then 15th century, the arrival of the Mughals was there. It means beyond, you will see that after Alauddin Khilji, there were the Sayyid and Lodi dynasty who rules like the Delhi and Agra till 1526. And then the Bengal, Jaunpur, Malwa, Gujarat and Rajasthan, the entire South India were independent rulers because the kings and their control was very less, and thus the independent kingdoms, they became their own rulers. And the different states, they also established at that time as they were the small but also powerful, like one of the Sher Shah Suri, who was in mid of the Mughal dynasty. You will read further, he was in mid of the Mughal dynasty, but before Akbar, but as he was from the different dynasty, so he came in Bihar. The place was Sasaram. He came here to look out his uncle's property, but he further attacked Humayun and became the king of and established the Sud dynasty and became the king of the Mughals. It means he was from 1540 to 1545. And further, he also challenged the Humayun on 1530 to 45 and 1555 to 56. Sher Shah captured Delhi and established their own dynasty, and as he ruled over the 15 years, 1540 to 1555. And further, they introduced also, it means they were also impressed by the administration power of the Alauddin Khilji, and they also took it over as in their administration. And further, the Sher Shah administration became the model followed by the great emperor Akbar from 1556 to 1605. As the Akbar, he was illiterate, but he became the one of the greatest kingdom among the Mughal empire. As you can say, in the medieval history, he became the greatest king. So the Akbar, he was also inspired from it. Apart from all these, we will see that the three orders, the peace, the god, knights and the crusades, these were at the time when during the 11th century when the church, because as we know that the beyond from other, we'll see the European countries, then we'll find that the Russian and the church that were having a more powerful, and that also became the one of the most powerful place from where they could control over the country. And thus the churches divided these into the three classes: those who used to pray, and those who used to fast, and third, those who used to till the land. And these were converted into the three groups, like the peace of God, knights and the crusades. And these, and their role was different, like they want that they should help in the emergence of new warrior group called knights, as the church patronize these groups, use them to propagate their idea of peace of God, as the direct warriors away conflict among themselves, because they also wanted that if they will conflict among themselves, then those Muslims who have been occupied the places in Jerusalem, they must be fought against them, because they wanted to escape their places, their holy places, Jerusalem, from them. As the churches, they consider that the Jerusalem is the holy place to them. And basically, these knights, they also did not belong to the class of nobles. But by the end of the 11 centuries in France and century in Germany, the humble origin of warriors was forgotten. And 12th century, the nobles also wanted to known as knights. See, the situation that was changed because the nobles at the time, they were considered the church, the nobles and the third estates. Basically, at the time of the Hitler's, the Napoleon's, sorry, Napoleon's, they were considered as the three estates was basically considered, and these were divided by the churches. Okay, dear students, read the paragraph and keep watching. Thank you.